Well, a little bit of work paid off. ZZ got right on it, and we found two drywall screws. Pretty beefy. That one there, the head was broke off, so we was able to chop in, and we barely made it past the bark. So, you know, we'll scale up the footage on this thing. We saved a butt log of poplar, and you can see how the metal detector really, really pays off. So, well, now we got everything scanned, loaded, and we're gonna go ahead and get to sawing here. So we'll see you at the saw cab. Hello everybody, we're gonna make you a Friday video, and it's gonna be a very poplar video, so let's get started. And we'll get all the stuff turned on here, and let's get the carriage back and let's find our first victim. So, I see my front tapers, he likes to creep out on me. I'm gonna watch that. Alright, enough of that, let's get the knees open up a little bit more. I believe these logs are a little bit longer than 8 foot. Beautiful. I kind of like it the way it's sitting. I'm going to bring it up just a hair. I like that. I'm probably the guy that rotates the log the most on YouTube. Alright, let's put the master dog down just for safety. Mr. Laser says that looks pretty good to get a face going. And it is very popular. Sounds like butter. Just beautiful, beautiful clear poplar. Take one more. We got a lot of meat on this log. When you pull clear wood off, you keep cutting it. All right, there's the first knot. All righty, let's bring it up a little bit there. Okay. Up with Mr. Master Dog. I'm gonna pull up this gear more. Texas. And that gives us some we can edge out there. Beautiful. like butter. Plus, they're sticky. Salt's kind of like white pine does. I'm just looking at my pit. We'll take one more. That leaves us a 9 1/4 inch face, or cam rather. All right, let's work north and south. Centered. Let's just work that other face and see where we end up at. Attention. just turn that up one more time, work it down a little bit more, and this log's getting about out of options. Dog that down, so let me see where we're at here. That's nothing even worth trying to take off, so we're gonna let that go right where it's at. There's nothing valuable in there right now. Let's get our next victim. Shop, so this is welcome to me. Yeah, it looks like we're about centered there, pretty good. Let's work north and south. I hate when the log comes up on that cradle like that. I try to keep them back. Let's go with that. bark on this poplar. That's a beautiful port there. Alright, where are we at in the fifth? Oh, let's work the other face out of this thing. Seven-inch port on the bottom of that to get still get clear lumber out of that. But going in my shop, I'm not going to bother with that. All right, we're getting into almost too nasty to deal with. We still got 8 1/4 left on that can. Half. got like, in fact, let me just take it 6 1/4. We'll make 2 3s. It's nice to have your blocking kind of consistent, especially the 4-inch direction. All right, let's just get on to 3. Good enough. Workhorse of America. went to the firewood pile. Oh, I just made a mistake, guys. Did you catch my mistake? All right, this counter loss is now too many things going on in here. So let's we're gonna cut a shim. In fact, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take it out and make it down a little bit lower in diameter. You see it right there? It's not gonna be a problem. I just want to get rid of when you're talking and sawing, and I'm going to take just a, I'm going to get back behind that mark. That's better. What I'm going to do is, these are going to get edged anyway, so that taper is not going to bother me at this point. We'll take one more, then we can make a true board out of that. Then we're down to 10 inches. Waste won't be so bad on that taper when it comes off. But that is a very common mistake made. And no, I don't want indicator lights in the cab. I don't want other things to look at. I got enough stuff to look at. All right, let's cut our shim now. Let's see what Mr. Laser says. There he is. I just want to touch the front of this into the saw. There we go. It wasn't too catastrophic. I only had a little bit of taper set, luckily. What a beautiful mark, though. I'll try to include that little clip in there of what we found in this log. It'll be in two videos, actually. Double boom. I'm gonna try to shove it back, see if it will. I think it's logged by the sprung a little bit. Let's see where we're at. Not too bad. Getting a little freckly here. Let's work north and south. Got freckles. Alright, let's look for Mr. Laser. There he is. Thank you. I'm just gonna split this. I don't think I'm gonna get enough usable lumber, so I'm just gonna go down to, let's go down to 4 inches. It's got a lot of freckles in it now. And whatever that is, I'm gonna split it. And that'll be it. I appreciate it. We're winding things down here. And do me a favor, could you please hit the like button? Could you please share it with somebody you know? And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And I will catch you on the next one. And I have no idea what we'll be sawing. Bye-bye.